Welcome back to Let's Play Amberstar. Ambermoon, I'm sorry. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, and we got trounced last episode by a zombie master, I'm presuming is Gordon, and a skeleton and zombie. They're very tough. They killed us both. We destroyed none of them. So I'm thinking this is something we're supposed to do later. Let's go back to the city gates. I gotta look for this bandit and leader. Hi. Yeah, I know. Okay. So, north of town. Which I'm guessing... We can't look at a map. But I'm guessing this is north. Silverhand, leader of bandits, headquarters, middle of desert, north of town. The ground beneath your feet suddenly trembles, and two huge lizards break out of the sand. Okay. Oh. Desert lizard. I keep forgetting to change our lineup here. What is wrong with me? I'm trying to have us stick together so we can concentrate on one opponent at a time. Flame spell? The monsters advance! The citrine moves to the side. Well, I didn't know you were gonna do that. I want us both to be able to hit one, so I'm going to move back. It's going to move over. 2 points of damage. Oof. Let it move over again, I guess. You know what? Defend. Because they've been throwing flame spells at us? That's a good idea. Okay. So. Hit it. And hit it. Retreating. Was it retreating as in leaving, or is it trying to be tactful? Is it a tactical retreat? It did 5 points. It did 1 point. Oof! 10 points, wow. Oh my god. You gotta be kidding me. This is tough. Wait, what does he have? Healing potion 1. No stink. That gives him, back like 1 hit point. If we can make it. They're both attacking him, that's the problem. Ah! Oh, wait. Is this? What does that say? graveyard. May Bela watch over the dead forever. Okay, on the map it says cemetery. Here it says graveyard. Well, in any case, I don't know. Which is harder? Which is the harder battle? It's really hard to figure out. Now, is that a random encounter, or is that fixed whenever we go over that part of the desert? I have a list of things I wanted to do, I think. I'm not sure. Oh, the lineup! The lineup! Fix the lineup. Oh, you dragged us. That's neat. I like that. Best we stick together, my friend. At least for now. It's just the two of us. Right, okay, I did that stuff. Sell or store things, graveyard, torches or merchant, and boots. Got it. I'm gonna save. Well, you know what I'm gonna do? Maybe pass. I just went straight that way. Should I pass over the bridge first and then go north? North is Hoiman Desert. Well, I'm saving for the express purpose of that we don't forget our lineup again. Yes, I am sure. Maybe we'll get more lucky. Do we have anything else? A strength potion. I don't know if that would help him hit more often, or it makes more sense that he would hit not more often, but hit for more points of damage when he does. I don't know how long it lasts or anything like that. And I don't know, like, what this is. We have a cure poison, healing potion, and strength potion. Maybe I'll have Edgel take the strength potion when combat begins with these things. Maybe if we stick to the road, it'll be safer. Well, the road has ended. How do I know we aren't just passing by this bandit hideout? Let me look at something. Looking at a map here. Well, I see the Alchemist Tower. That's quite far away. Yeah, I don't know. The bandit, wait. I'm looking at this. It's in German, but it's fine. It's Spannenberg. Is that Grandpa's house? Or is it the bandit's house? I think it is his Grandpa's house. Oh, crap. Stand by. By the water over there. Ah, we're losing daylight. Hmm. Oh. Maybe this is the bandit hideout. As you go towards the door, a bell suddenly rings in the house. Too late! You notice the pull cord at ankle height, you hear loud shouting in the house, and then it is deathly still. We tripped a trap. Maybe it's best to find another way in. I don't think there is another way in. Well, they'll be ready for us. What are you gonna do? It looks as if the house was left in great haste. On the table to your right lie playing cards spread around wildly, and there on the dining table to your left there are several bowls of soup which is still warm. Why would the bandits run from us? And we have combat music, yet there is not yet combat. On the north wall of the chimney, Edjo finds a small lever covered with rust. Do you want to move the lever? Yes. Slowly after Edgel moves the lever, you hear a creaking sound to the northeast. Alright, cool. We've opened a secret thing. Is it either this northeast or it's probably that? Those stairs probably weren't not there before. You hear noises behind you, and you turn around. Several dark shapes have suddenly appeared from nowhere behind your back. They have dangerously long knives and attack you without a word. Do they? Okay. Bandit, bandit, bandit. Alright, well, we're gonna split our attacks for now. Though I don't like doing that. He did two. I failed. He failed. Edgel did five, nice. I did two. They are not hitting us, I approve. Although we're now not hitting them. Three points, Edgel, nice! Now I know this one is damaged, but I'm gonna have both of us switch and focus on this one for now. Three points. Fail. More points. 1 point! Guy's gotta be hurting now. Leather was broken. Wait, is that Edgel's leather? Bandit retreats. We advance. We attack. You can't move that way. Okay. Advance. We insist on killing you, sir. I forgot to have him attack. We did 1 point of damage on him. Here, get him back for that. we're not. Advance. Advance on the enemy. 5 points. Boom. Okay, so it's his leather broken, right? Not Edgel's. 165 gold and 9 rations. What am I doing? I'm used to having to click something to pick up something. We will bring all these to sell. Our leathers are fine. Our weapons are fine. Great. Well, I'm gonna cheese it since I can. No! I don't want to load. So yeah, quite a... No, I don't want to quit either. Quite a bunch of battles here. So each one represents, I guess, a trio of bandits. So then we've got 12 of them to fight. At least not all at once, could you imagine? Alright, so attack. And attack. They're gonna wear us down by attrition eventually. 2 and 3 though, it's not bad for a start. Points. 3 points. Same as our first round. Our AC is working well, I believe. Five points. Boom! I'm gonna keep him fighting this one. I'm gonna just start on this one. Because that one on the right is probably more than half dead. All action, all missing! There you go, 2 points, 3 points. Needs to be the 2-3 point combo here. They have yet to get a single hit through. Just that one bandit at the end hit Edgel for 1 point. 5 points, boom. Okay, you should be breaking morale about now. 4 points. You're not. Okay, you're an exceptionally dumb bandit. Okay, here he goes. Advance! And attack. 1 point is all it took. Okay. 67 XP. Bunch of gold. Rations. We're gonna buy that chainmail yet. Just you watch. Just you watch and wait. Alright. Didn't want to do that. It'll take me a while to get used to this new system here. Oh, I'm at my limit. And he's getting close. Well, probably what we'll do is drop all the daggers and keep the leathers. The daggers send for itself a 10, 12 gold pieces, I think. Unless I'm remembering the price from Amberstar. So we cheese it again. Cheese it again. It's gonna take me a while to remember. And to not click that. Hello. We have come to end your life. Enjoy. 3 points. Fail. It would be funny if one group of bandits was unexpectedly tough. 1 point. Actually, this might be tough for them. I'll take these guys over the Zombie Master and Desert Lizards any day. At least until we level up a few times. Now, Edgel's got a few hits in. That one on the right might be close to folding. Boom! He did 2 points. On Agile, I guess? Oh, on me. Oh, I got hit for the first time. Look at that. What a shame. Yeah. 4 points. Nice. The one on the left. It's about to be gone. Boom. Die, sir. At least we're polite about it. Please die, sir. I would be most obliged if you would perish at this point. 1 point. My points. He's gotta have like 1 point left at this point. 2. Oh no, he's still got a little bit of fight in him. We insist on killing you. Poof. Now let's see if we can even carry this, Edgel. He's full of leathers. Oh, looks like... I'm actually going to leave the daggers. I'm going to pick up the rations and the gold, though. That's going to give him even more weight, though. 34. This is saving. Yes. And finally, you guys. Just reducing the bandit population for the good of mankind. Now I'm gonna switch to this guy so we just gang up on him when Edgel kills him. It's too far away. Oh, to hit him? I didn't mean to do that. Actually, it's most probably gonna happen. I'm gonna end up soloing that last one while Edgel tries to move around and might not do so in time. Oh, see what I mean? Yeah, we do. We can't advance because this guy's stopping us. Damn it. He's covering for him as the guy runs away. Bye. Can I move him up here now? Join the fight. Points. Nice. Okay. Agile has reached level 2. 6 training points. Attacks per round are still 1. Life points now total 31. Boop. Boop. Ah, we're full. Look at that. Can I drop some stuff without leaving that? Look at it fly off the screen, that's cool. Whee! It doesn't seem to be making a difference. Get rid of all of them. I want to keep one just in case. Well, we didn't really accomplish anything then. We're still in this screen though, that's cool. And I can pick up the other ration. It's just we can't pick up anything else. Alright. I keep hitting that. You know what? I'm trying to click in the window to make the little thing go away and stop the ghosting of the... But that's not what you do. I think I'm thinking Baldur's Gate, maybe? So we've got the kitchen here. I guess here we might be able to find more rations, but we don't really need any. Hard to tell what's interactable and what isn't. Okay, got a bedroom here. Who's better? We probably both stink at it. Mind trap 0. 0. We heard a strange sound. Agile works on the padlock as normal. He probes carefully around it until a click is heard. Unfortunately, it does not come from the opening mechanism, but instead triggers an explosion. Citrine is lucky and escapes the trap. However, Agile does not. Oh, look, someone ran away. Look at that. Now, I can't resurrect people yet, so... Alright, so we can't open that. It's trapped. We don't have a way to undo traps. What about this? Nothing. Can we take things off the walls? No. You know, I heard that... Well, that just brings us here. Of course, we can't discover any traps because we have zero chance to discover any, so... I guess once we finally get a rogue, we'll be coming back to some of these places. I thought maybe I could bash it. Like, I could bash the chest. But I don't know what I would select to do that. Just as you approach the stairs, several bandits come running up the stairs out of the cellar. The largest one shouts, "Nagir does not like unwanted visitors. Let's cut their throats." Alright. Oh, Bandit Chief. Oh, boy. We probably have nothing to fear from these guys, just him. Let's go into defend. And defend. Short bow. The Bandit Chief is hanging out back there. Unfortunately, well, these two are probably going to attack me, and these two are probably going to attack him. But should I... kind of torn if I should just gang up on one of them. Let's take out these. Bandit Chief did 10 points of damage on Agile. Oh boy. Chief Agile, 3 points. I wonder if he could have slept in one of the beds. 16 points. Let's wait. Let's give him one more round, and then I'll heal him with that. Failed. I'll give it one more attack. I'll say that much. These guys are all failing, but we have to kill them to get through to him. Bandit Chief. Failed, good. Maybe we'll find some potions in here. Failed, nice. Keep failing, Bandit Chief. So we're not doing much better. Feeling good. 4, nice. Okay, 1 down. Okay. I'll have him switch to this guy. Fifteen? Oh my god. I might have to reload if he gets another hit through because... Oh wait, we're not done. That last bandit. He's got 1 hit point. So the bandit has to fa- I should have healed him before. I know. I'm trying to save it because I only have 1. But I think now that he's level 2, I think it heals 2 hit points? Still, it's like nothing. I'm spending all my rounds just healing him then. Oh, what are you gonna do? Let's see if we can do this. So I'm gonna heal him. Please do not connect. Oh! Oh my god, 18. Okay. So I went in here. And then I went in here. I mean, if we did rest, we're only healing up 2 and 2 hit points. We'll probably get attacked, but maybe see what's up the stairs. Maybe we'll find some cool equipment and such. And we, like, put off fighting the bandit leader. Instead, there are these guys. Look at that. They all of a sudden, boosh, change into their thief outfits. They keep moving all around. Alright. So more of these battles. Maybe one of us will gain a level. Maybe I'll level up. Alright, just bandit. Maybe we'll find some cool things up here. I don't know if maybe using a lockpick would bypass a trap. I'm thinking not. Points. Let me do 1 point. Poof. There's like another 9 up here. So can we kind of have to grind for levels? Kind of wondering if I should cut this out, guys? I don't know, it's interesting to me so far to watch, but it is just the same enemies over and over again. So now we can go bring Edgel back to town and train him some more. And maybe that'll help him connect with hits more. Getting up in the- wait! I thought I hit attack. I don't know why we have to click OK to advance. Okay, please to attack him. Thank you. 4 points. Boof. Yes! Citrine, level 6! 42 max hit points, power points 41, or they were already 40. Does that mean that's the old and that's the new? 41. Spell learning points, training points. Yeah, sweet. Too bad it doesn't give us the ability to carry more stuff. I don't think we need any more rations. Should we... I forget, I can click Y. Oh, there's only 2 here. That's cool. I'll defend then, and wait for the other one to come up. 5 points, nice, Edgel! Three points. Wow. That was well done. Just move him around, loop to loop. I'm trying to move, not attack. You're a toast, mister. Poof. Short and sweet. We're dropping something else. I want this money. I'm gonna drop the dagger. We do have a replacement short sword? Yeah, just in case. We have 2, actually. Alright. Hell with the dagger. Whee! Ah! Still can't pick it all up. What do we not need? Oh, the leather? Well, no, that's to sell. Short sword. Let's get rid of one short sword then, I guess. See, in Ambermoon, you'd quit out and you would not have the screen anymore. It would be gone. Your turn. Just one. Huh. Advance. We are bold adventurers. Because you're probably not going to hit us at all. Three points. 4 points. One point. Oof. Short and sweet. Yeah, I'll drop rations next, I guess. Here's a chest, which we probably should not trust. Edgel has almost opened the lock on the chest when you hear a hissing sound. In seconds, the room is filled with a green vapor. And he's dead. So, homie, don't play that. This is the end, then, of episode 14. I don't have a way of getting into that chest, at least as far as I know. Actually, let me try something, actually. Before we actually end... Well, I have to select one. Oh, and I'm poisoned. I mean, I have cure poison. Oh, boy. I'm down to 5 hit points. No. We can't disarm it. We have nothing with which to disarm it. Oh! It bypasses traps. Well, looky that. We got gold horseshoes, a sword named Firebrand, a dexterity potion, and 5 more lockpicks. Ooh, love it. Alright, well, 1,000 gold. Can we just leave the gold here and then come back? Because that's really, really heavy. As it is, I think you could store things in chests. Maybe not this one. Damage plus 15. Warrior and Paladin. Well, we know who gets this. Oh, I didn't mean to use that. Ah! Okay. We can put in chests. I wonder if things can remove them from chests. I don't know how heavy that is. How heavy is this sword? That's what I'm wondering. I have to click it every time. Alright, so... Oh, the gold horseshoes! That's what he was looking for. Luckily... Oh, it's not zero. Well, what we want most of all is this right now. Dexterity potion would be handy as well. Firebrand, his attack goes from 9 to... What happened? Oh, it's a one-handed. Edgel does not have enough hands free. Oh. This unfortunately brings his defense from 12 down to 11. That's not bad, though. And his attack from, what was it? 8 to 15. Nice. So he has 11 defense, I have 10. Oh, he has more defense than me. Still. Oh, that's right, because he had less hit points. He has more hit points now. Hmm. So how about this? How is his weight? Thirty-one. Okay. So it's what? It's 1,000 grams, I think. So it's 1 kilogram. I think that's the way it is. Alright, so yeah, extra long episode. Let's remember to come back and get this stuff, including the gold. Especial. So now we have more lockpicks, we can try to unpick the lock down below. Behind a loose brick in the chimney, Citrine finds several items. Another 500 gold, another gold horseshoe, a target bow. Damage plus 12. And a constitution potion. It's pretty sweet. We have... It's a drink. It's a refreshing drink. We have potions for all our stuff, you know? I wonder if we can take that gold. Wait. Did we take it? I think we took it. It just popped us out automatically, though. Alright. So, wow. Long, long episode. Fun stuff. So check back for next episode when we fight the bandit leader, and hopefully we have better luck this time. Maybe we'll try sleeping in one of the beds, possibly. Well, thanks for watching, guys. See you next time, and always, seek adventure.